In this video, you're gonna learn about the top 10 variables you should use within Google Tag Manager. All or more, coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with another video for you. Today we wanna talk about Google Tag Manager variables. Now, variables are like placeholders within Google Tag Manager that let us fill our tags, triggers, and even other variables with this placeholder information. They get resolved during the page load and can hold different values. Now, I don't want to get too much into how variables actually work, but I want to tell you about the 10 variables that I use most often within my Google Tag Manager deployments. So without further ado, we've got lots to cover, so let's dive in.
All right. Our first variable is the data layer variable. If you have a nice data layer on your page, you'll be able to pull out the data that is stored in the value of a data layer and transferring this over to a data layer variable right here. To do this, simply go over to Google Tag Manager and create a new variable of the type data layer variable. And what you would need to enter is simply the key that you want to pull out. So in this case, when we look at the data layer and we want to pull out the value of our visitor logged out, we would need to know the key, which is written here in black, the visitor type. Just enter this into the data layer variable name field and you'll be able to then pull this out of the data layer and store it in a variable. Now there are a few other tricks to this data layer variable, but we have a separate video on it that I'm gonna link up down below if you wanna check it out. Next up, our auto event tracking variables. Now, if you have a auto event trigger installed, so for example, the click trigger or one of the user engagement triggers, you will likely want to enable all your auto event tracking variables. What does this mean? So for this click trigger, you go over to your variable menu and configure your built-in variables. And here you will find certain auto event variables that you can enable. Just click them and they will be enabled for you in your account. Then you can head back and try out your click trigger. If it's already installed, we'll just head over to our page, reload this, click on the add to cart button, for example, and then we should see in our variable menu the enabled auto event variables right here. And not all of them always get filled, but if they get filled, they have some important information that lets us distinguish our different clicks from each other and make sure our filter within our auto event trigger is correctly filled. So for example, here the classes is transferred, or the add to cart, which is the click text of our button. And this is vital information that we can later use within our trigger, but then also within our tag. So definitely enable your auto event trigger variables if you are using an auto event trigger. Number three, the Google Analytics settings variable. Now, when would a Google Analytics settings variable be useful? Well, if you have Google Analytics installed through Google Tag Manager and you have several tags that are sending data over to Google Analytics. You might know the tag template of Google Analytics, where you have many different settings that you can choose right here. And a settings variable is simply a variable that will fill out all these different fields based on one variable. So for example, here we have the tracking ID in here, and this is something we would need to repeat all over again in our other event tags, for example. So for convenience sake, we can simply build a new Google Analytics settings variable that will pre-fill this tracking ID field. So we can go and build a new Google Analytics settings variable and fill in our tracking ID once, save this. And henceforth, we have it available here in our settings variable dropdown and can choose this, and we'll get rid of the enable override settings in this tag. So all the settings that would normally be put into these fields here are now governed by one central variable, our Google Analytics settings variable. So it makes our lives easier because we know that this is all governed by one single variable, our Google Analytics settings variable. It also makes it easy to expand our tracking because we'll be able to go into the settings variable itself. And let's say we wanted to send a custom dimension with all of our page views and events. We simply would need to go into the settings variable and then choose the right dimension right here. So we'll add a custom dimension and can use another variable to fill this out. The same is true if you had a setting that you want to set on all pages, like anonymize IP to true or the cross-domain tracking settings. Once defined in the Google Analytics settings variable, this will obviously also transfer to all your tags that you have already installed. So the Google Analytics settings variable is essential when working with Google Analytics and Tag Manager. Next up, the URL query variable. Now this variable is particularly useful if you see any kind of query string in your URL and you would like to get this information. For example, here it would be the search term that was entered into the search bar into some kind of tag or use it in your triggers. So with the URL variable, you can easily pull this out. Just go over and create a new variable of the type URL and then choose as the component type the query type. Then you just need to know the query key, and the query key is whatever is in front of the equal sign of your desired value. In our case, it would be simply S. Then give it all a name. And we should now have it available as a variable to use inside of our tags and triggers. Next up, the referrer variable. Now this is a variable that is already built in and also enabled by default. So you should be able to find it under your variable menu really easily right here. Now what does this variable tell us? It's actually the URL that the user just came from before he entered this page. Hence it's the referrer to this website. This can be quite useful if you just entered the page. So for example, right here, if I go on a search result from Google and come to the page, our referrer should have something to do with Google. So let's look into the referrer variables. And here we go, we have a referrer from google.com. Now we could utilize this to always fire a tag when somebody comes from google.com, for example, or we could also utilize this in our other tags to send that data to our analytics tools. And our sixth variable is the first party cookie variable. Now, if you navigate around with Google Tag Manager on your page, you know that the preview mode reloads every time you go to a new page. That also means the page view, DOM ready and window loaded, appear new in your preview mode, and the data layer gets filled with new data. Unfortunately, Google Tag Manager cannot remember anything that was going on beforehand. Each page load means a new loading of Google Tag Manager. In web development, you can persist the data, and commonly there are cookies used to do this. Now you can set cookies with Google Tag Manager, but that's a topic for another video. For now, we just want to view the cookies that are set on our browser. We'll open up our Chrome menu here to go into the developer tools. And here we get some useful information under the application tab and cookies right here. We can see what data was set through different code on our website. Now, in some cases, there's more useful information. In other cases, it's unusable because you don't really know what it exactly means. But as said, you could actually also set your own cookies. For example, this cookie here is this user newsletter subscriber was set to true. Probably he came from a newsletter source, and therefore we can identify this user and we have written this information to the cookie. How can we make this useful now in Google Tag Manager? Well, we can pull out this value from our cookie by building a first party cookie variable. All you need to do is go over to Google Tag Manager and under the user defined variables, we'll choose a first party cookie variable as our type. And we need to have the name. In our case, the cookie name is newsletter subscriber. Give this all a name. And this should now pull out the right value from our cookie. And voila, here we go. So maybe have a look in your cookies, what useful information you could pull out with this first party cookie variable. Next up, the DOM element variable. Now, what does DOM stand for? It stands for the document object model. This is how our site is marked up, and we can simply right click on any element on our website and click on Inspect Element in Chrome, which will open up the Elements pane here and give us the visual representation of the document object model. Now with the DOM element variable, we'll be able to pull out any kind of node that we are interested in and get either a attribute or the text in between those elements. So for example, here, if I wanted to pull out the cart menu and the amount of this cart menu, I would need to either know the ID, now this element doesn't have an ID, or the CSS selector. Luckily, there is a class of amount which we can utilize in our variable really easily. So let's head over to Google Tag Manager, and here under variables, we'll go into our new user-defined variables and click on the DOM element for our variable. The selector method is this time CSS selector because we don't have an ID. And we had a class, so we'll write a dot here and amount. You need to know a little bit about CSS selectors in order to do this effectively. And then we can choose the attribute that we want to pull out. Since we want to pull out the text, we can leave this empty for now. And let's give this all a name. Save this. And let's try this all out. And here we go. We get the DOM card value of $48. And it pulled it right out of the page. Getting more advanced, we're gonna take a look at the lookup table variable. Now the lookup table variable has different use cases, but the easiest would be to simply rewrite an existing variable. So for example, we have already had a variable that we created earlier that would pull out the value from our cookie, newsletter subscriber true. Now if you use this inside of a event tag, for example, you would simply see true in the action and you wouldn't quite know what this means. So you would like to rewrite this variable into something more recognizable like subscriber. This is easily possible with the lookup table variable. Let's head over to Google Tag Manager and build a new user defined variable. And this time we'll go with our lookup table. Now the lookup table really works like an if this then that statement. If what variable? In our case, it would be our cookie variable. And then we can add certain rows. If the input is true, then we want to rewrite this into subscriber. If the input is false, we'll rewrite this into non-subscriber. And the default value, if something else happens, we can just say unidentified. All right, let's try this out. Give this first a name. And see what happens. We'll go back to the page, reload this. And our variable that we had before shouldn't change. We still have cookie newsletter subscriber true, but rewritten, we should have this in our lookup table variable. Here we go, as subscriber. Now what happens when this is actually false? Let's change out around our cookie just to simulate. Gonna reload the page here. And we should see our lookup table subscriber is now non-subscriber. And our cookie just stayed as false. Now lookup tables can be used for many different other circumstances, and we have some videos linked up down below if you want to explore this more. Next up, the regex lookup table. Now what you might have noticed is that when we created our lookup table subscriber variable here, we needed to be very precise with the names. If I type in anything else, or put a white space in here, this wouldn't match up anymore and we would just get an undefined in our field value. Therefore, the matching option that we have in this first input column is similar to equals to. So the cookie newsletter subscriber needs to equals true in order for it to go into the output subscriber. But what we also have available is a variable type of regex lookup table. Now what is regex? Regex stands for regular expression. And if you're familiar with regex, you know that you can really get detailed in your search query, which can be very powerful. So for example, let's take a more advanced case. Let's say we would like to classify all product pages like these into a product category. So we would like to have an output of product simply to classify all product pages, and we can have one for category pages as well. We can easily do this with a regex table. So we can come over here and say the input would simply be the page path. And we can add here if the page path contains anything like slash product, and I would need to escape them, then the output should be product. And if there's a slash category in there, then the output should be category. And we probably also need to match the spaces afterwards, right here and before. So what I will do is surround this by dot stars, which means everything multiplied. So let's put this in the front and the back here and see if this works. Let's save this and refresh. Refresh this page. And in our variables, we now see the regex table has the name category. We are on a category page. We're looking at the URL right here, or the URL path, and this matches up. And if you go to a product page, we have the same result with the product now, because we looked at the URL again and we matched up this part that is inside of the URL. I hope you understand that you can become more sophisticated with regex in this regex table than you are with the normal lookup table. And this can be very valuable, for example, for content grouping in Google Analytics, or if you look at the referrer, you could be doing channel grouping really effectively and send this on to Google Analytics easily. So regex table, really an advanced feature which can be quite powerful in Google Tag Manager. And we have come to the final, the champion, the variable to rule them all, which is the custom JavaScript variable. Now, the custom JavaScript variable is probably the most versatile, but also the most complicated to write yourself, or the easiest to use if you just copy code in. But to be honest, the custom JavaScript variable could potentially be used to replace all the variables that you have seen in this video, because JavaScript is the technology that is powering Google Tag Manager, and therefore we'd be able to do everything that Google Tag Manager does with JavaScript in this custom JavaScript variable. So let's go with a little example here. In Google Tag Manager, I can simply go over to our user-defined variables again and create a new custom JavaScript variable. In here, we need to adhere to some conventions. One is to write an anonymous function that returns a value. So I'll put this in right from the start. In between, you can execute any kind of JavaScript code. You obviously would need to know a little bit of JavaScript and return a value. Just as an example, let's go with the current time, which we can get by writing new date. And let's return this time. We'll give this all a name and save this. Let's refresh our page and see in the variables what this spit out. We see here, this gives us back a variable of the type date with our actual current date and time. And this should dynamically change. You see it here at the second level, that some of these are changing depending on when the event loaded. Again, with a little bit of more JavaScript, a little bit of more code, you could probably make this quite useful. For example, to send in a custom dimension into Google Analytics to have the exact timestamp of when a hit was sent over to Google Analytics, or to calculate how long a user was on your site. But I won't have time to explain to you right now how this would work. I just hope that you understand the potential of this custom JavaScript variable. And luckily, we have tons of more videos on the custom JavaScript variable with use cases on this channel, linked up down below.
All right, so there you have it. These are my top 10 variables that I use within Google Tag Manager. There are more out there, and there are also many other use cases for these specific variables. And I'll leave it up to you to give me your tips down in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you as always. And if you haven't yet, consider subscribing right over there, because we bring you new videos just like this one every week. Now, my name is Julian. Until next time.